If you're a homeschool parent teaching your kids Spanish, the body and parts of the face in Spanish is one of the first topics you need to cover. Kids tend to have an interest in things they can relate to and interact with, like their faces. Using fun activities and resources is the perfect way of getting kids and teenagers to focus their attention on learning the parts of their body in Spanish. Welcome back, Spanish learners, to another episode of Spanish Academy TV. Where improving your Spanish with the best content available online is our main objective. You know how it's a bit of a challenge finding fun Spanish materials for kids? Each child is different and learns at their own pace and needs. In order to support you, I've got a great and entertaining lesson with activities and free resources for teaching parts of the face in Spanish vocabulary for teenagers and kids. But first, if you haven't done it yet, please make sure to like this video, subscribe to our channel, and turn on that notification bell. It couldn't be any easier. And by following these three simple steps, you'll make sure to stay up to date with our amazing Spanish content. Just like, subscribe, and notification bell. Knowing how to identify the parts of the face in Spanish is guaranteed to prepare your kids for having important conversations. Whether it's a health emergency, part of a game, or to build more Spanish vocabulary, this is the ideal lesson to get started with. Let's begin our lesson by covering the words you need to know. The basic parts of the face in Spanish are la cabeza, head, la cara, face, el pelo, hair, el ojo, eye, la nariz, nose, la oreja, ear, el diente, tooth, la boca, mouth, la frente, forehead, el labio, lip, la barbilla, chin, la lengua, tongue, el bigote, mustache, la barba, beard. Now let's extend our vocabulary with a few more words in Spanish for the face. La ceja, eyebrow, el párpado, eyelid, la pestaña, eyelash, la mejilla, cheek, el lóbulo, earlobe, la mandíbula, jaw, la fosa nasal, nostril, la sien, temple. Keep practicing these parts of the face in Spanish with your kids by doing an exercise such as pointing them out and locating them in front of a mirror. Now that you've got the vocabulary down, it's time to take it for a spin by using endearing and motivating strategies and activities. Kids don't learn because they have to. They learn because they want to. Depending on your child's age, you may need to consider different methods and materials. While younger kids can learn perfectly with routines, songs, and games, teenagers require something extra that they can relate to. Let's take a look at different methods you can use for teaching your kids the parts of the face in Spanish. 1. Daily routine. Incorporate Spanish words for the parts of the face for kids under 12 who follow a daily routine, from brushing your teeth to washing your face. There's plenty of options to use. You can use commands such as, vamos a cepillarnos los dientes. We're going to brush our teeth. Pon el jabón en la mejilla y la frente. Put the soap on your cheek and forehead. 2. Self-portraits. If your kids are into arts and crafts, use this interest to your advantage when teaching them Spanish vocabulary for the parts of the face. Have them draw a self-portrait using crayons, markers, or Play-Doh. You can have them describe the portrait and identify the different parts of the face using Spanish words. Or use commands like dibuja una nariz, draw a nose. ¿Dónde está la boca? Where is the mouth? 3. Monsters. Prepare your kids to draw some wacky monsters. This activity is also ideal for kids under 12. Get 2 jars and fill them up with pieces of paper. One with numbers and the other with parts of the face in Spanish. Start this activity by asking them to pull a piece of paper out from each jar. If they pull a número tres, number 3, and the word nariz, nose, then your child has to draw a monster with 3 noses. You can motivate the students to get creative by pulling out as many papers as possible to make different combinations. If they're already more advanced in Spanish, you can ask them to describe the monsters by using phrases like mi monstruo tiene 3 narices, 4 bocas y 2 ojos. My monster has 3 noses, 4 mouths, and 2 eyes. If your kid hasn't reached that advanced level of Spanish for describing monsters yet, you can sign them up for a free trial class with us. Our certified kid-friendly monsters, I mean instructors, from Guatemala can't wait to improve their fluency and make them feel more confident about their Spanish. The lesson can be tailored to your needs and has flexible scheduling options. Just go to www.spanish.academy/free-class to sign up now, or click here. Let's continue with our list of activities for teaching parts of the face in Spanish for your kids. 4. Face scramble. You'll need a couple of magazine cutouts for this entertaining activity for kids under 12. Get a picture of your child's favorite character and cut it into pieces. This will transform the picture into a puzzle your kid needs to solve by calling out the parts of the face in Spanish. Use questions and commands like ¿Qué parte de la cara es esta? What part of the face is this? ¿Dónde va la nariz? Where does the nose go? 5. Flashcards and posters. Kids love posters, and they're ideal for any age. Not only are they great for decorating spaces, but they're quite effective when given educational value. Make sure to place a poster with the parts of the face in Spanish in an area that your kid passes consistently. Flashcards are also a great teaching resource. You can use them any spare time you have and take them out for a quick practice run. Visit this blog post to request our free Parts of the Face in Spanish posters and flashcards. 6. Songs. Kids of every age love songs. They're great for youngsters and even for teenagers. They're a great resource for learning and reinforcing grammar, vocabulary, pronunciation, grammar structures, and rhythm. Check out Canción de la Cara for the little ones, or visit our list of 10 kids' songs about body parts in Spanish for inspiration. 7. Makeup tutorials. Pay attention to teenagers or young kids who are crazy about makeup by combining parts of the face in Spanish vocabulary with easy-to-follow makeup tutorials. Look for makeup and face painting tutorials in Spanish and watch them together. This activity allows you to add bonus vocabulary like colors, objects, and following instructions. 8. Games. let's wrap up our list with an activity everybody of all ages love. Playing games. Simon dice, Simon says, is great for following directions and asking your kids to point out different parts of the face in Spanish. The commands in Spanish go, Simon dice, toca tu nariz. Simon says, touch your nose. Simon dice, toca tu frente. Simon says, touch your forehead. You can also get your kids to practice vocabulary by challenging them to a good old-fashioned game of Pictionary, Hangman, or Tic-Tac-Toe. Just keep in mind to switch up the dynamics by tossing the different parts of the face in Spanish into the mix. This list of activities is guaranteed to keep you busy and your kids engaged with this useful and essential topic. Follow my instructions or come up with your own alternatives for using these strategies for motivating your kids to learn the different parts of the face while using Spanish vocabulary. There's plenty of different possibilities and other ways to engage them so they can become better, confident, and fluent Spanish speakers. You can also download our free ebook, Weird and Wacky Spanish Stories for Beginners. It's a magazine-style ebook with pictures and English to Spanish parallel text. Not to mention, it's also fun for both kids and adults who wish to improve their fluency through reading. All 6 weird and wacky stories are packed with vocabulary and will keep you super entertained. Thank you for joining me for another fantastic episode. Pick up other Spanish learning strategies for kids by tuning into this next video about Spanish number games. See you next time. Adios. I hope you enjoyed this video, and don't forget to leave a like, subscribe to our channel, and click that notification bell to never miss the best Spanish content on the web.